Good evening, traders. John Caruso coming to you here. It's Sunday night. We just had the futures markets open up just a couple hours ago. But first, we're going to do a quick recap of last week. Relatively quiet week up until about Thursday when the Biden administration released their capital gains tax plan, effectively doubling the cap gains tax on the wealthiest Americans. All in all, we did see the S&P 500 finished unchanged on the week. The NASDAQ was down 0.6%. The Russell 2000 was up 0.57%. We'll take a look at the S&P 500 first. We actually do believe that the S&P has a little bit more upside in it ahead of the Fed meeting on Wednesday. We're going to put a target area of about 42 to 4220 on the upside. Keep that in mind. I'm going to flip over to the energy here real quick. We did see oil down 1.5% week over week. We closed above 62. We've called 62 a key level. It's got to hold that 62 level to continue to fight for maybe 65 to 68 on the upside over the course of the next few weeks. 60.85 on the downside is key level for crude oil. You start seeing closes below 60.85, then we're probably going to attack the high 50s again. So keep that in mind. 60.85 on the downside, 62 on the upside. Those are your two key levels. Natural gas up 1.3% on the week. We did see a larger BCF draw than expected. A lot of it has to do with the cool, unseasonably cool weather that we've seen here in the Midwest. Natural gas, from a chart standpoint, actually looks pretty good right now. It's just lacking a good fundamental story to continue to carry the price higher. Gold finished, where are we at here? Down 0.1%. on the week. Gold actually, it is bearish trend on a 6-month trending basis. However, it looks okay here in the near term that it could attack above 1800. 1750 on the downside has to hold. If you start seeing 1750 give way, then 1800 is probably out of the question here in the near term. So long as we're above 1750, I think we're going to go 18 to 1820. Silver actually looks better than gold right now. We think silver could attack 27 to 2750 on the upside before maybe it sees some static resistance. Copper, Hulk size move last week, up 4% week over week. Looks fantastic. We do think it's a little bit technically overbought right now. I'm going to give you a range of about 438 on the upside, 412 on the downside. If you see 412 again, it's probably a good buying opportunity, so keep that in mind. Platinum, another good week for platinum, up 2% week over week. We did see a strong move on Friday, but it quickly rejected that 1250 area with pretty good conviction too. So 1250 is kind of the ceiling right now for platinum. We start seeing multi-day closes above 1250, you're probably going to see it take off to 13 relatively quickly. On the downside in platinum, 1200. Nice round numbers, 1200 to 1250. That's your range. You start seeing closes below 1200, well, potentially look out below. Taking a look at the dollar. Dollar down basically in the last 4 weeks, down 3%. We saw it attack north of 93. You saw a lot of the shorts bail on their short positions, a lot of the weak hands, and here we are moving straight down pretty much in a straight line. Last week, it was down 0.8%. Technically, it's oversold right now. We could see a modest bounce in the dollar, but we likely believe it's not going to get far. Taking a look inversely to the dollar, the euro currency was up 0.9%. We saw it bottom out at the end of March at about 117.34 on the downside, and we've done nothing but trade higher since, pretty much in a straight line. Right now, we're trading above 121. Seasonally, there is a sell recommendation coming up at the end of the week on the euro, but just like the dollar, inversely, we think any pullbacks in the euro, they're likely to be shallow, they're likely to be short-lived, so keep that in mind. That's all I have for you right now. Good luck this week. We'll likely see you back here on Wednesday after the Fed meeting. Hopefully, we can recap the Fed meeting for you. That's all I have for you. Have a great night. Take care.